Now illegal hunting is a big issue in Malta.
Go to places like Delimara, Minzip or Dingley Cliffs, you will see hunters literally every 10 meters. Most of these trapping sites, hunting hides, are illegal.
They've seen a Montagu's Harrier shot and it's actually gone down.
They shot down an osprey.
They've been shooting at pretty much every raptor and they've shot down quite a few today.
They were everywhere in every field. There were turrets by the cliffs with guys stood in them just waiting for birds to come over.
This is about reclaiming our countryside. And this is about, obviously, international conservation.
Tourists could not come on here and go for a walk.
The officers out there checking these hunters, unarmed, checking armed men, a very, very long way from hell.
The Maltese falcon, the last pair, was shot in Gozo in 1980s.
Someone shot at their car from up here with a rifle.
What 400 illegal hunters can do. They can do as much as, you know, kill most of the birds that come in.
This bird is not going to fly. So I think it is kinder to put him to sleep. And we try all to protect these birds, and then they fly over Malta, and they end their life over here. This has to stop. This has to stop.
There's hunter. Man with gun, man with dog gun. Four men with guns. The scale is unimaginable. Europe spends millions of euros protecting these birds, creating habitat for these birds. Hundreds and hundreds of thousands of volunteer hours, all donated free to protect these birds.
Shooting of protected species is a crime all over the world.
This bird was shot 2 days ago, and we also have the veterinarian certificate. What we have here is another immature honey buzzard. And as you can see here very clearly, a massive gunshot wound to the wing.
They shoot them for fun, for sport, for no other reason.
We heard a shot and saw one of the flamingos go down.
Recently we had two honey buzzards. One of them unfortunately had to be put down. The other one we have here in this training room. It's been shot in the wing and we think that it can be rehabilitated. Hopefully it will be released in the coming months.
There it is, it's banking. That's been shot at, no question about it.
Had we not been there in our groups, then I think many of those birds would have been shot out of the sky. Purely for sport, purely for some of them to put it into their taxidermy collections.
The bird specimens we have, which apart from the odd one or two cases, all were confiscated from hunters and taxidermists. Anything from a wood warbler, to flamingos. We've got Cory Shearwaters, the bulk, marsh harriers and kestrels. Other species which in Europe, especially in the UK, thousands of pounds are being spent for the conservation. Great bittern.
There are collections which amount to several thousands of birds.
There was a flock of about 26, if I'm not mistaken, short-tailed eagles circling over the islands in the afternoon, finding a place where to roost for the night, and practically all were shot.
We've been left some messages here. Firstly, a honey buzzard dead, a lesser kestrel. You can see the gunshot wounds. And then lastly, we have a marsh harrier.
We heard a shot and we feed the pellets.
Yeah, and it was quite clear that they had been hit by lead shot.
Many people are afraid of reprisals. If they either report to the police, some have had dogs poisoned.
He was confronted by a hunter and actually shot in the face.
The hunters were not satisfied and they demanded more. They took to the streets, they marched to the parliament, they beat up the journalists, they threw beer bottles to the parliament and they fought with the police.
All three cars had been burned. The fire engine was coming back again to continue putting out the fire.
Condom, rebel jolly.
Hunter came storming out of his field. He started swearing at us, many Maltese. He threatened us. One of the species that we've seen them targeting in particular is night herons. We saw a bird at Luat Airport with its leg dangling from gunshot wound. They then spend a couple of days wandering around, slowly starving to death or dying from the wounds or infection in the wounds. So this is an adult night heron. It hasn't been dead for very long. It doesn't smell too badly.
A series of SMSs which were going around urging hunters to participate in an illegal protest, taking with them
petrol, matches, batons, sort of a very violent protest.
The police are on their way and they're going to confiscate the shotgun.
And the car got. Oh, nothing.
It has cartridges?
Yes, yes.
Ah, it's loaded. Look at the charge on that.
We checked the serial number of the shotgun.
Just
we know him already.
Okay. We found two caltrops. 10 pieces of wood with 4 nails hammered through and upright. And one of them was very well hidden.
Go home, bastard! Bastard! Go home!
But it's not because we're killing them.
We were sort of being surrounded from people coming over the top of the hill, round behind us and coming down. People coming up the hill towards us.
Don't take photos for us. Take it. Take out the film.
Listen, you were hunting there. You had a shotgun. We know where it is. So relax. Police is calling. Hello.
The windscreen has been broken, and we found both tires have been slashed with a knife.
Caught the hunter shooting, and you confiscated the gun.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yes.
Okay. Gotcha.
I'm against anyone who comes up with the usual idea of boycotting Malta. No, come to Malta, but do something about it. Write to your MPs, write to the Maltese authorities. They do take notice, I know.
Malta is a fantastic place to witness the migration, and we need your support from Europe, from Africa, to come to Malta and help us. This is about conservation efforts in Malta and Europe, and this is about Malta's reputation.